brennen du Sonnenschein, und damit dir im Wald allein. Weiter brauch ich nicht so glücklich sein, Wochenend und Sonnenschein.
Greetings, YouTube misfits, misgreens, malcontents, and misanthropes. Claire's here with her coffee. Come on in, grab yourself a cup. We're going to talk about YouTube and YouTubers. A few of you have expressed disappointment that I haven't uploaded a video of late. Not since about this time last week, as a matter of fact. And you may have noticed that I really haven't been on YouTube very much. The fact is that real life intervened and I was very busy last week, even during the evenings. As a matter of fact, I was so out of the loop, I didn't realize one of my best friends on YouTube, Rith Randell, had closed his channel. On making some inquiries, I found that he had chosen to do so for very unfortunate reasons. It seems he's been harassed unmercifully and very cruelly by a certain YouTuber I consider to be a sociopathic reptile and a blot on the YouTube landscape. I'm not going to mention his name here, but I will say that he's literally not worth a bucket of warm piss. Now, I hope Rith comes back someday. He's an entertaining guy, and he brings a lot to the table. That's enough said on that subject. I was so busy last week, I never got around to putting together even a short video that revealed the winner of the People's Choice Dim Bulb Award. And it was an exciting contest, a virtual dead heat between two of the nominees. Just to remind you, here are the four nominees from last weekend. Pardon me, but someone insists on getting in on the action.
I'm covering a very critical topic today. It's the gay agenda mentioned in the Bible. Homosexuality is being pushed by our White House. Do you think we're in the last days? Absolutely.
I don't know a lot of stuff, and it's a necessary greenhouse gas, and it is not responsible for the temperature of the world increasing.
You see, for many, many years, we believed that each one of those layers was put down over long periods of eons of time, and yet Mount St. Helens has caused us to literally rethink all of that.
You know, you come onto this channel and you put down Christianity as if you want people to not respect or to think that Christians are stupid or bad or ignorant, okay?
A very worthy group of dim bulbs, and in an average week, any of them could have won against a lesser competition. But we can only pick one, so here is your vote count. With 11 votes, in fourth place, Neptune Knives. So sorry. In third place, with 22 votes, End Time Ministries and his homosexual agenda. And, almost a dead heat, we have Rise 2 Cents with 34 votes, and Brad Arub with 35. Congratulations, Brad. I always love giving it to somebody who rapes, pillages, and plunders geology.
Were ye born?
Are you depressed now by that Stygian darkness radiating from all of those dim bulbs? Well, you ain't seen nothing yet. It's time for this week. You may recognize our first nominee. He's Brad Harub, and he's back this week not to misinform you about basic science or geology. No, he's here to warn us about the culture war.
I know we hear the term culture war thrown out on occasion, and in fact, I think in many cases we become desensitized to that term. But I want to start by bringing it home to you for just a moment. The most current research is showing that it takes four Christian adults just to get a single faithful Christian into the next generation.
Well, Brad, perhaps the problem is your atavistic message is unconvincing.
I want you to think about all of the different things that our young people are seeing today. You think about the attacks on their faith, evolution, atheism, humanism. You think about the attacks that we see in the court system, and you begin to realize that, yes, we really are at war.
Brad, the only people I know who have declared a culture war are Bible-banging bugwits like you, who are just simply pissed off that your religious ideas cannot stand critical scrutiny in the marketplace of ideas. Our next nominee is another old friend. James the Street Preacher is here to tell us what he's going to do when he becomes president.
We've got a lot of problems, ladies and gentlemen. I just want to share with you briefly for a few moments some things that I would do, James the Preacher, if I was a president of the United States of America. I'd bring back prohibition. Some of these things may sound old-fashioned to you, but I tell you, we were better in those days than we are today. That's the very first thing I'd do is bring back prohibition. I'd make some ADA agents, some alcohol destruction agents, ladies and gentlemen.
Apparently, when James was homeschooled, his mother skipped civics. He has a somewhat spotty understanding of our system of government. Presidents do not make laws. Presidents enforce laws. Making laws is the purview of the United States Congress.
The second thing I do is I would make the teaching of evolution against the law. I'd ban it from our schools and make it a mandate that they make curriculum bringing God and the Bible back into our schools, ladies and gentlemen.
After all, what has science ever done for us?
The third thing I would do is I'd bring back the death penalty.
Most likely for such heinous crimes as card playing, dancing, and laughing on the Sabbath.
And I say put the one who has the abortion and the one who commits that abortion, that doctor, put them in jail and on a short period and then put them on death row because they're murderers. Amen?
There are times when James says something I can't make a joke about. Our next nominee is new to Coffee with Claire and Dim Bulb nominees. He actually has a PhD just like Brad Arup. The unusual thing is that his PhD is actually in geology. I give you Emil Silvestru.
Now, because I'm a geologist, the moment I can accept this much water, doing so much geological work, I can easily visualize the vast majority of fossils and sediments being laid down in this global watery catastrophe.
As long as one is willing to ignore the details and the complexities of the sedimentary rock record of the planet, and one is willing to ignore the simple fact that the fossil record is an ordered sequence documenting the history of life on the planet. In other words, we don't find Cambrian cows, and we don't find plesiosaurs with porpoises.
If I look at a deep or a very deep column of sediments which contain fossils of various levels of organization, all theological bias aside, I can only interpret it in two ways. One would be slow accumulation over time, with animals slowly evolving, or it could be also the result of a sudden deposition in a watery catastrophe with the animals selectively buried, like the most primitive, of course, at the bottom, and this is where we find most of the fossils, because they attach to the bottom, or live very deep down there, and then gradually more and more developed animals because their normal habitat is closer to the surface.
I see. So this organism ran to higher ground, but that organism didn't.
There's this very vast domain of geology known as metamorphic rocks. You can take any kind of another rock, and because of pressure, temperature, and chemicals, it changes into a different rock. That's known generally as a metamorphic process. Well, thus far, and the way I learned this in school, is that there are different kinds of metamorphic processes, some induced by temperature, some by pressure, some by fluids. But my personal experience in the field has actually shown me that I can interpret virtually all metamorphic formation as a result of fluids. So then, that's exactly what I had during the flood. Immense volume of fluids moving through the entire planet and, of course, changing the rocks.
Anyone with an undergraduate degree in geology, anyone, knows that Silvestru just lied his ass off. There are minerals within metamorphics that can only be formed under great pressure and great temperature. I defy him to show me the chemistry by which he can produce large crystals of andalusite, kyanite, or sillimanite in a lab under normal atmospheric pressures and normal surface temperatures. Despite the fact that we have three thoroughly dim bulbs today, there's no real contest. The winner is Dr. Emil Silvestro. If some of you are a little surprised at how easily I picked Emil Silvestro as today's dim bulb, perhaps I should point out that I didn't share everything with you. I've watched over 3 hours of the man, and there's scarcely a word that comes out of his mouth that isn't just plain wrong with regard to geology, or is a damned lie, or is some absurd speculation based upon his firm belief that the book of Genesis is history. As a matter of fact, there's so much material, I'm afraid I'm going to have to devote an entire video just to Emil Silvestro. Look for it. I'll try and get it up soon. Bis später. Take time for your pleasure. Laugh with love. Take the hand of another. Sing for the wings of a dove.